Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and today we're gonna be diving into some animation and we're gonna be talking about importance of axes in animation. That's like the core basic for you to understand. And we're gonna be talking about some curve editor and a certain reference coordinate system called parent. Now, but most importantly, we're gonna be animating this pendulum and we're gonna make it swing and rotate, etc. So our renderendulum is gonna look fly. So let's start first with a parent reference coordinate system. So I believe a lot of you know what, you know, a couple of these reference coordinate systems are. So I'm gonna compare our parent to view and world. So when you go to view, and if you click on the front view, you can see that y-axis is up, x-axis is on the right. When you click on the left view, y up, x right. Y up, X right. But when you click on your perspective view, you can actually see a different story. You can see that Z is actually up, X is on the right, and Y is in the back. That means that this is the actual state of the axis here, and these just don't respect it. So in that case, you want to switch to world. Now, when you switch to world, you can see Z is up, X is right, and you can actually see all these things kind of respecting that logic throughout the viewports. So on the left view, Z is up, Y is in the back, etc. Now, parent. What does the parent do? Parent practically works the same as world, but with only one difference. In animation, every object that you have is either a parent or a child. That means that every object in animation is in the parent reference coordinate system. So how does that work? I'm just gonna show you a basic example of that. So if I create a teapot, let's say I have a teapot here, right? And you can see that the z-axis of the teapot is up and the z-axis here of our pendulum is up. And I'm just gonna link these two. So if I link the teapot to the pendulum, right? And if I rotate the pendulum like this, its axes actually become unchanged. But if I click on the teapot, you can actually see that it rotated this whole axis of that teapot. So the whole logic between child and parent, which we see here, is that whatever the parent does, the child will always completely follow. So if you just tilt your object like this, its core axes are gonna stay unchanged. But if you tilt the object like this, the child will literally tilt its whole world to that new position. And that's what the parent reference coordinate system does. If now I switch from parent to world while having my teapot selected, you can see that it's literally showing how the world coordinate system looks like, and Z is up, left is left, right is right, etc. So with animation, it's super important that you're constantly working in the parent mode. But now let's start animating. We are gonna be animating this pendulum and it's gonna be swinging left and right, and we're gonna spice things up that when it swings, it's actually gonna rotate around itself. So yeah, you're gonna see why. So to start animating this whole thing, we're gonna go to the helpers tab and we're gonna click on point. Now I'm gonna create this point in my top viewport. Why? Because everything created in Max is always created in the top viewport. So what does that mean? If I go to my teapot and I want to create it in the front viewport, it's going to be created from the top. If I want to create it in the left viewport, it's going to be created from the top again. Why is that important? Well, because if I go to my local reference coordinate system, you can actually see that the z-axis is now, well, here, and it actually should be up. And with animation, I mean, for a complex animation, it's super important that all the axes are kind of looking in the same direction and that they are properly created, or you can have a lot of problems with that. But that's a different story. You see, this is the thing. Animation can get complicated super damn fast. Like, you can try and do some, I don't know, basic stuff, and it will just blink of an eye, it will get stupid. So yeah, you need to be very careful and you need to kind of plan carefully your animation steps or else. Anyhow, so we created our helper, we created it in top viewport. First thing we're gonna do, we're gonna just align it to our pendulum and I'm just gonna move it up and we're gonna move it somewhere around here, right? So next, we're gonna link our pendulum to our helper. And from this point, you can actually see that if I'm rotating this, yeah, it acts like a pendulum, it works fine. In this case, our helper is a parent and our pendulum is a child, because whatever the helper does, pendulum just follows. So let's do a basic animation of this. So let me just turn on my auto key. I'm just gonna rotate this to the left 40 degrees. I'm gonna go to my 25th frame and I'm gonna rotate it the other way by 80 degrees. And I'm just gonna click on this first keyframe because I need the end to be like the beginning, and I'm just gonna clone it to the very end. And what did we get? We got this. And yeah, that's our pendulum, but we want our pendulum to also swing 360. Now, this is where the things start to get a little bit complicated, because look at this. If I go here, and if I wanna just rotate this 360, you can see I cannot do that. I can actually try and go to the local mode and rotate it by 360 here, but our animation is practically gonna look like crap. So this is what we're getting. First, we have the middle keyframe, and then the rotation starts happening after it. So in that case, I'm just gonna open up our curve editor to see why that is happening. And that's because our middle keyframe is just blocking the rotation. So now you see that we have Y axes, which are just swinging things left and right, and we have the Z axes that is trying to do some rotations, and this is the blockage. So if I just delete this, start the animation, well, it doesn't really look like things are moving the way we want. Let me quickly just show you why. If I select all my three curves here from the rotation, right? And if I go back to where I started creating this rotation element in a local mode, because that's the only mode that looks okay to do. So look at this. When you start to move things, all three curves start to just wiggle around. And this is not a healthy scenario, because you just need to have one curve to create the 360 rotation, and that's it. You don't want to mess with all three curves so that you get it right, etc. So for that reason, our child parent thing will kick in again, and we will create another helper. And that helper is going to follow our main parent, which is just going to swing, but that helper is just going to be still, meaning its orientation, world orientation, or parent orientation will stay the same, meaning we can just make a casual 360 animation of that, and we'll be using only one curve, and it will work. So let me go back to the beginning, where I just linked this whole pendulum with my helper. And what we're gonna do in this point, we're just gonna create another helper, we're just gonna clone it down, and then let's just make it smaller. And it's also good kind of to organize things. You may even try to color it differently so that you know that it does something different or whatever. Let's just reduce the size of it to something like this. And this is what we're gonna do. We will link our RenderRam pendulum to this little helper, and then we will link this little helper to our main helper. So how does this look now? We have RenderRam as a child, this helper as a parent, and then this helper as practically a grandparent, because it's like the master helper, which is gonna, you know, control everything. So let's start the whole process from the beginning. Let's rotate this by 40 degrees to the left. Let's go to frame 25 and rotate it 80 degrees to the right. Clone the first keyframe to this side. So in this point, you can see we only have in our X, Y, and Z rotation. So X is flat, Y has that rotation that we just created, and Z has it flat. And you see this, like if you just go and wiggle this around, you can actually see how our rotation is actually being affected. Now we are gonna select our additional helper here, and you can see, since we are in the parent mode, you can actually see that the Z axis is just oriented on how our main helper is oriented. So look, it even follows completely whatever he does. So in that case, you can just go to the very end of your timeline and just go to the rotation mode and do the 360. Now look what happens in the curve editor. We have only one axis being created. So let's just rotate this 360 degrees. And look at this, our X rotation flat, Y rotation flat, Z rotation, it's the only one that has a change. We don't have that moment where we had three curves just, you know, jumping around and doing stuff. Let's just start our animation and see where we're at. So look at this, we got a nice rotation, nice 360 rotation, but there's one thing missing. I want that rotation to kind of be continual, and you can see that near the ends or near the beginnings, the whole animation kind of slows down. So nice rotation, slow down, nice rotation, slow down. And that's because of this curve, where you can see it has like an easy in and easy out. So when you select your points here, you have these little blue handles, which are called tangents. And tangents can be modified. This tangent is showing that things are gonna start to happen slow, and then they're gonna go to a linear movement, and then they're gonna slow down near the end. And this is exactly what is happening, because when I click play, you can see that in the middle it kind of has a fast movement, but near the edges it kind of slows down. So let's try to make this linear. There's a couple of ways how you can make curves linear in Max. One way is you can literally go on manual and just try to do it like this. But the more, let's say, sophisticated way is to use a linear button. So let me just expand this a little bit. So here you have all these buttons. I highly encourage you to check out, just create some animation and start pressing these buttons and see what they do. I think you'll get it pretty quickly. But this one is the linear tangent button. When you click that, it's just gonna make everything flat. You can also access these buttons by just right clicking on a keyframe, and you can here, you can choose which one of these you want. So it's pretty much the same. It's just the difference is with these, when you just go to right click here, you can choose what happens before the curve and after the curve. So this is the before the curve and this is the after curve movement. Okay, so we made the curve linear, and let's just play our animation from now. When you click play, as you can see, we got a solid, nice rotation with the pendulum swinging, and we created that by using two helpers, and that's pretty much it. So yeah, that's practically the topic of the day. I just wanted to show you how the whole parent and child correlation is super important in animation. Like whatever the parent does, the child will always follow. And that's super important because it will make your life easier when you're doing animations, because then you can just separate the movements, you know, like this helper is only doing this, this one is only doing this, and it's all controllable by a single curve. And you don't need to have those scenarios where you move, you know, one thing in the space and, you know, three curves just start jumping around, and then you need to figure out the hell is going on. And that's it for today, guys. As usual, don't forget to check out Evermotion website, because their Arc Models Volume 276, it's Desert Plants, it's 25% off. If you take a look at this animation, this was made with that pack. This looks absolutely stunning. I mean, look at the detail on everything. It just looks... it looks real. You know, it's a nice pack to have, because like you can just scatter various objects, and the guys in Evermotion are just doing their best to deliver the best possible objects you can have. And yeah, check out Arc Models Volume 276. It looks absolutely sick. See you in the next video. Bye.